5. Chicago, the Fan.
Chicago, I'm Brian Noe. He's Dane Fife here on The Fan. Very pleased to welcome in our next guest, Matt Eberflus, Bears head coach, former defensive coordinator with the Colts. You know, Jimmy, who's playing the music here today and doing many other things, coach, he said, we're playing Sinatra coming back, whether you like it or not. Are you a Sinatra guy? What is your wheelhouse musically?
Well, I would say that I do like Sinatra for sure. I mean, he's obviously iconic, but I'm more of a country guy.
That a baby!
Who's your guy, Dane?
Eric Church is my guy, coach.
You like Eric Church, coach?
Yeah, that's a good one for sure.
Eric, hey, I got one for you. Clayton Anderson, he's a Bedford, Indiana guy. He's about to go big. Don't forget that name. I'll remind Mr. Faber about Clayton Anderson.
Okay, sounds good.
So if we go Eric, if we don't go Eric Church, who do we go with? Are we going old school?
Well, yeah, I would say that I want to say Kenny Chesney's one of my favorites.
Okay,
so, yeah, kind of old school.
You're a linebacker in college, a country fan, country mute. You have my heart.
You sound like you're doing the combine evaluation of Clayton Anderson there. You know, that's what you sound like.
He's 6'4",
yeah.
Mullet.
Right.
Great twang. Great,
good 40
great
time.
Voice, yep.
Yeah, you got that in there.
Big drinker.
Yeah. Coach, how's it feel to be back in Indianapolis for this go-around of the Combine?
No, it's good. I mean, you know, 1 year later, you know, so we have a really good understanding of where our roster is and what we're going to do. And we got a great opportunity ahead of us. You know, we got a lot of cap space, and we got all these draft picks. And with the first-round pick, we got opportunity and flexibility really to add to our football team.
Coach, when you do these radio interviews, honestly, I'm not going to ask you about it, but you know most of these interviews are like, you're at number one overall, you're going quarterback, you're sticking with Justin Fields. Like, do you ever just kind of roll your eyes going into the interview like, oh, gosh, this again?
Well, you know, we know the questions before they're asked for sure. You know, we just want to make sure that we look at everything. You know, we have the opportunity to really keep our open mind and make sure we can make good decisions with knowing all the information that we have ahead of us.
When you are bombarded with those type of questions, it makes me wonder, what's the question that you would want to answer that you aren't being asked when there's so much focus on the number one overall pick?
Yeah, that's a good question. I would just say that the culture of our team, you know, how good it was last year, you know, obviously going through adversity, we were close in a lot of games, but our guys, and a credit to our players, a credit to our coaches, a credit to the staff, the support staff, that really just did a great job of having a mindset of a great attitude every single week and working together to build that culture.
Coach Dane Fife here. You played in college, you coached in college, and now you're a head coach. You're an assistant in the NFL. Now you're a head coach. What is the biggest difference in college in terms of coaching than it is the NFL?
Yeah, that's a good question. You know, it's really not that much difference. You have to really adapt and adjust a little bit to the age of the player because your range of player is a lot wider. So, you know, in college, you're what, you know, 18, 19, yep. 21, 22, somewhere in there. Now you're 22 to 32, 22 to 38, you know. So there's a wide range. Guys that have families, guys that have houses, they're, you know, in the middle of their life. And, you know, in their career. So you have to adjust your style a little bit. You know, it's really more of a partnership when you're in the NFL working with the players. And you're still of service to the player like you are in college, but I would say that's the biggest thing.
How much is a player's personality or a player's how they are in an interview? How big of a role, if he's got numbers, if the numbers add up, if he's got the size or got the talent, Is it feasible to think that you might not take a player based on personality or his interview?
Yeah, I would say, you know, really the most important thing is the tape. You know, so his number, evaluate the number first. Mm-hmm. And does he have passion? Does he have love for the game of football? And does he show that on the game tape? That's number one. Secondly, does he show it in practice? Because guys that love football, they love it in practice as well as they love it in the games. And that shows because you can't cheat the game. How you practice is how you play. And then you move from there and you say, okay, hey, you know, is he a teammate that we can work with him? He can be working well with others. You know, his team ability is good. And then from there, you make your choice, you know. But he has to first and foremost love the game and have passion and show that on the game tape.
Can you tell when a player doesn't love the game, Coach?
Yeah, that's easy to see.
Gosh,
it's easy
even
to see
at the that level.
Too. It's easy to see the love, too. You know, you can see it. It just jumps off the tape.
Yeah. What do you love most about the combine here, the week that is?
Yeah, I just think it's really a chance for us to get to know the players better. And again, this is just one small part of it. You know, obviously the medical here is the most important thing, but, you know, get a chance to spend 20 minutes, you know, 30 minutes with the guys and get a chance to know them a little bit better. Then we're going to take our off-site visits to the pro days and get a chance to maybe go eat dinner with some of these guys and spend some more time. And this is just one piece of the puzzle.
He's Matt Eberflus, Bears head coach, joining us here on The Fan. You know, Coach, I think about the team that had the number one overall pick last season, the Jags, and they went from 3-14, and they were a playoff team this past season, had a plus 500 record. Do you see that possibly happening with the Bears? Same record, 3-14, but maybe making a jump and winning as many as six more games, maybe more, in 2023.
Yeah, I mean, you know, this year we were super close in a lot of games. You know, we were 1-7 in one score games, and we were very competitive against a bunch of good football teams. And keep adding talent and, you know, one more year in the system to develop these young guys that we have, you know, and then just keep moving forward. And we're excited about onboarding this whole group of guys that we got coming in free agency in the draft. So it's going to be a big process for us. We got a lot of work ahead of us, and it's 58 days before the draft. So a lot of work. So we're excited about that.
I promise you this isn't a loaded question, but gosh, it sounds like it. This is not me trying to figure out what you're doing at the quarterback position. I promise you, Coach. Just when you look at the roster as it is right now, who are some of the players that you're most excited about being back with the Bears in 2023 and seeing what they can do?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm not going to give names right now because, you know, that's a competitive advantage for others, but I'm just going to really just say that, you know, we are excited about a lot of young pieces. You know, the guys that we draft, the draft class that we had last year, you know, Braxton and Gordon and Brisker, you know, Sanborn, all those guys have really put their, you know, really, you know, first step was really good for those guys. And again, they have continued to develop.
You know, I'm just thinking, Coach, where I'm thinking about the rookies that you had last season. And then I'm also thinking about a guy that you brought in during the season, which is Chase Claypool, who was the wide receiver with the Steelers. I know he's a vet, and I don't know the perfect way to ask it, but which is more difficult? Is it to get a rookie and to get him up to snuff with what you do with your team specifically, or is it a guy who comes in mid-season and you're trying to make that happen?
Yeah, I think it's probably harder mid-season because, you know, when a rookie comes in, he comes in for rookie mini camp. He's got the whole summer. He can study the playbook. He understands, you know, the motions, the shifts, and the formations, and all the things that it takes, you know, to run the routes correctly. And I think that when you come in mid-season like that, I think it's very difficult, you know, to be able to implant yourself into an offense and learn it on the fly. And I think that takes time. You know, that takes time. That's really a credit to Clay. You know, he's really working hard to get that done. And now he has more time to be able to learn the offense going into this offseason.
A lot of conversation about food always at the combine, Coach. Like, what's your go-to? You a steak guy, chicken guy? How do you get down?
I am not. I'm more of a seafood guy.
Okay.
I'm more of a seafood guy, and I really don't. I stay away from the red meat most of the time.
Not bad. So fish, scampi, what do you do?
Yeah, I like fish. Of course, I like, you know, white fish, you know, different various types of white fish, sea bass, all that. So I like that.
Very nice. Well, Coach, thanks for taking some time today. We really enjoyed it. Enjoy the combine week and hope you get a lot of good work done.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, fellas. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, thank you. There he is, Matt Eberflus.